The following presentation is brought to you by Push Black. Push Black is a Black-led nonprofit devoted to uplifting Black voices. Please consider donating and supporting Black-led media.
What's good? My name is Tré Melvin, and can we take that back? Hello. Hello, my name is Tré Melvin, and today we are going to be talking about Rosa Parks over my third bottle of Crown. Let's begin. Rosa Parks was born in 1913 in Tuskegee, Alabama, a southern state in the United States of America. Her mother was a teacher, her father was a carpenter, and she had a little brother named Sylvester. After her parents separated when she was 11, Rosa's mother said, "Fuck this shit and fuck this nigga," and moved Rosa and her little brother Sylvester to Alabama's capital, Montgomery, for a fresh start. Rosa loved to learn and studied hard as fuck in school. I was about to say, am I allowed to cuss? Like, this ain't my set. But sadly, she had to leave school at 16 to care for her sick and dying grandmother, and shortly after, her very sick mother. As I was saying, when she was 19 years old, Rosa married a barber by the name of Raymond Parks, who encouraged her to get her diploma and to graduate high school. And that's just what the fuck she did. Went back to school, graduated, and began work as a seamstress in Montgomery. My good sis was in her bag sewing blouses and coats and socks and shit. As we all know, life for niggas was, well, bullshit. At the time, the United States operated under the Jim Crow laws, a set of laws introduced in the late 19th century that claimed to give Black people separate but equal status and treatment. But in truth, there was no equality, like, at all. Created by jugs of mayonnaise, I mean white people, who claimed that Black Americans' lives didn't matter as much as theirs, these laws enforced racial segregation and allowed for discrimination against Black Americans, referred to at the time as colored people. The Jim Crow laws were introduced in different ways, you know, varying from state to state, but there was one common goal: to make sure Black people and white people led very separate lives. Black children in the late 19th century and the early 20th century had separate schools than white children. Among other things, we had separate libraries, bathrooms, fountains, restaurants, waiting rooms, etc. And each state saw to it that the Black schools, churches, libraries, etc. were mustier than the white ones. In some areas, there were laws banning Black people from sporting events and even working in the same office as white people. Black Americans had far fewer rights too. Racist-ass laws, referred to as Black codes, restricted us to low-paying jobs, made it nearly impossible for Black people to vote, and made it extra possible for Black people to be arrested and jailed for stupid shit. In the face of such racism, Rosa said, "This some bullshit, actually." Together with her husband Raymond, she joined the National Association for the Advancement of Colored People, also known as the NAACP, which worked tirelessly to put an end to segregation and discrimination. Towards putting an end to discrimination and segregation. But it was on December 1st, 1955, when Rosa truly sparked change. After a long ass day of work, Rosa boarded the bus home, sat her Black ass down, and at the time in Montgomery, the seats toward the front of the bus were reserved for white Americans, and the seats toward the back of the bus for the niggas. The bus filled up quickly, and when a white man boarded the bus, the driver said, "Niggas, get your ass to the back." All the niggas said, "Say less, got the fuck up," except Rosa Louise McCauley Parks. On some bullshit, they called the police. Rosa was arrested and she was fined for breaking segregation laws. But Rosa said, fuck that shit, refused to pay that shit, and argued that the law was wrong, not her behavior. Upon news of Rosa's arrest, the black citizens of Montgomery came together and agreed to boycott the city's buses. The date from Rosa's trial, December 5th, 1955. Nigga said, bitch, fuck you and your bus. I'm about to whip out these feet. The boycott was managed by the Montgomery Improvement Association, for which Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. was elected as leader. The protests proved incredibly effective, with more black people participating than expected. And since black citizens made up 70% of bus users, the city's transport services didn't make no money, and then motherfuckers was like, wait, are we going bankrupt? But it was not an easy protest. Many of them did not own cars, so they had to carpool together or walk far as fuck to get where they needed to go. On top of that, the boycott was, as expected, met with dangerous acts of violence and aggression by musty-ass white people. Nevertheless, the protesters stuck together and fought for their cause, and on November 13th, 1956, their efforts were finally rewarded. After 381 days of boycotting the buses, the Supreme Court ruled that Alabama's segregation laws were musty as fuck, aka unconstitutional. In light of such a wonderful victory, Rosa Parks became known as the mother of the civil rights movement. Sadly, despite the victory, life was not easy for Rosa and the activists following the boycott. Faced with continued violence and threats by snake-ass white people, Rosa and her husband moved to Detroit to live with Rosa's brother. There, she continued to promote civil rights and help those suffering from discrimination and injustice. And in 1987, she co-founded the Rosa and Raymond Parks Institute for Self-Development. I ate that. To provide career training for the youth in Detroit. Rosa received numerous awards, including the Presidential Medal of Freedom in 1996 and the Congressional Gold Medal in 1999. I studied for this test. For her strength, for her courage, for her very rare patience. Because baby, let me tell you something, baby. No, baby, listen to me, baby. If it were me, on that goddamn bus. Rosa died of natural causes on October 24th, 2005, at the beautiful age of 92, but she continues to be recognized all over the world as a symbol of freedom and equality. Today, commemorative statues stand in her honor, or should we say, sit? No?